that right?
Yeah, I think it's the ones you can't see, they're the ones that are more danger, because probably still half the size of this boat underwater and they're easy enough to sink us and you don't even know they're existing, so... He said there's definitely a different smell in the air. If they're upwind of you, you can smell... Almost you can smell the frozen water rather than just the sea air. And then when we went past one, there was a distinct smell I could smell, but it might have been one of the guys on deck, I'm not sure.
A little bit more up. Down a bit.
And had pretty strong winds, sort of mid-30s. We've gone well, pretty much positioned in the middle of the fleet in terms of north-south in second place. But now we're in a situation where basically the race is restarting. There's no wind ahead, we keep buffing into the back of it. So very frustrating right now. We're losing all the miles that we've gained over the last 3 or 4 days.
A lot of the time when we're down here in the Southern Ocean, we need four people on deck because you can't actually do anything with three. So Will and Charlie, who are on their own floating watch, who in the last couple of legs managed to get a lot more time looking at the computer screen on this phone, on this leg, that had spent a lot more time on deck.
Lizzie.com.
I probably should have packed slightly differently. I packed as a navigator. I haven't got quite enough pairs of socks or gloves to deal with being on deck for 6 or 7 hours at a time. When the breeze is up and the gusts are particularly high, we have a hand on each sheet and we have someone on the grinder, so you've got to have four people on deck. Otherwise you have to have a reduced sail. So in order to push the boat, you need the four people for safety. So that means Charlie and I are up there. So that means we run a normal watch, but we've also got our other duties. So that's fine, it's part of it.
I wish the keep a fast mode for a while.